Hello, I'm Ellie for Edu for Java, and this is to, and in this tutorial I'm going to explain the concepts of variable types and expressions. We're going to make another project. If you remember the last tutorial, we did our first Java project called Hola Mundo, Hello World. We're going to start this new tutorial in another project to learn basically how to create projects, create classes. Okay, let's call the project variable. The names of the projects are normally written in lowercase. Okay, finish. Inside the folder source, let's create with the right button of the mouse a new class. We are going to call this class variable. Let's check again the public static void main as before, which is the method where we're going to write the code which we're going to do. The same thing as in the last tutorial. And finish. As you can see, a class was automatically generated called variable. And we can see it's public. And inside the class, it has written all this. These are comments which we're going to delete. Inside the class variable, we have a method. This method is called main. It is the main method. And inside the method, we're going to write our program. In between these places, clicking here, we can see all the content of the method. The title would be the description, and inside the braces are the instructions which are going to be inside the method. A program, let's see. How can we define it? It's like a kitchen recipe. Imagine we're going to prepare a cake. We would need to put flour inside a bowl, put eggs inside a bowl, put milk and beat. A program is a sequence of instructions. In the last tutorial, we learned that we wrote CISO and we pressed Ctrl space, and automatically Eclipse helps us and writes this. We learned that this is an instruction that wrote on the console anything we wrote inside here. For example, I write eduforjava.com, and it would be written in the console here. To execute this, we went here, run. Another way of doing this is to click right button on top of the class we want to run, and go to Run As. Press Java application, and it's just the same thing. It run. The first instruction was executed, and it wrote edu4java.com in the console. For example, if we write a second instruction, one that says fin, the end, and we run it again, It first executes the first instructions, which says print on the console, edu4java.com. And then it runs the second instruction. We wrote fin the end, so it writes fin. This quotation marks here are to tell the program to write just what is inside. When we see variables, we will understand better the quotation marks. Let's define a variable now. A variable is like a space where we can keep things. It can be of different types. Imagine if I have a space and I want to keep, let's see, a small cat. I'm going to have a small space to keep it. And if I want a space to keep an elephant, I would need a bigger space. When we ask Java to create a variable, we have to tell Java how big is the variable, so it knows how much space it has to reserve. Let's now create a variable to keep a number. We also have to define which name we're going to give the variable. We really can name it as we want. We can even put just a letter. In this case, we're going to name the first variable A. We're going to write that inside A. We're going to put an integer, for example. A is going to be a variable where we're going to keep an integer. An integer is a whole number. In Java, the keyword int identifies the simple type integer. Just writing int space A, we are telling Java that we are creating a variable called A. We could call it B too, but this time we're going to call it A and of an integer type. After the program is run and that Java goes reading and running everything we tell him. You remember that before it read and wrote this and then the other one. When it reads this other instruction, Java is going to reserve a space in its memory to keep a number, and that space in the memory is going to be called A. We can after fill that space with something, with anything we want. For that, there is another type of instruction. To A, I assign a 1. This equal here doesn't mean equal, really. This equal means assignment. With this instruction, we are telling Java that in the int type space, we were keeping with a label called A. In this variable A, we are telling him to put a number, this number 1. There isn't any problem putting 1 inside A, because A is an integer type, so it can keep a number. Another way is telling Java to keep a word. Hello, hola. Words in Java are always written between quotation marks. It gives me an error. If we see why, it tells me it can't convert a string. In Java, a word is a string from string type. It can't keep this inside an int type variable because this variable is an int type variable. We are going to keep in a number. As you can see, we have two instructions. These instructions which creates a space in memory to keep something, and this other instruction to keep inside that variable, to keep inside a number. We can also write these two instructions in one. For example, I'm going to write b equals 2. Here I'm doing what I did before in two instructions. I'm doing it in one. I'm creating a variable b, and in the same instruction I'm telling Java to keep a 2 inside the variable b. To demonstrate that a has a 1 inside, we are going to CSOC, control space, as before. Later on I will explain you everything about this magical instruction, why it has dots here and why these letters are uppercase and these other are lowercase. For now we know that every time this comes up, everything inside here is going to be printed on the console. This time, instead of putting a word in between quotation marks, we're going to write a and we run as. As you can see, our 1 was written on the console. The first instruction wrote a 1, the second instruction wrote edu4java.com and the other one fin, the end. Let's delete this one so that it's easier. We repeat and we see that the first instruction wrote a 1. Why did it write a 1? Let's see. When I write A without quotation marks, Java understands that I'm not writing a word. Java understands that I'm writing an identifier. In this case, the A identifier corresponds to the variable A defined here. And that in the second instruction of our program, we assign a number. When we tell Java to write on the console A, Java understands that A is a position in memory and it goes and fetches what is inside and it prints it for us. If we want to print the letter A, we would have to write it between quotation marks. If I write it between quotation marks, see what happens. An A is printed and not a 1, because when I write anything between quotation marks, I'm not talking about the variable A, but of a word A. Let's continue with the variables. Let's print B now. One and two. First one and then two. Let's define a variable int C now. Now we're going to assign C A plus B. This here is an expression. This is a mathematical expression.